I do want to go back into the solo talk real quick, and we'll start again. I hate going in order like this, but I'm going to do it just for the sake of simplicity.
I don't want to go first.
Okay, Jess, you're going to go first.
Oh, origin story. Origin story.
Okay, you're going to talk about what you did before you came into the space, the podcast space. So you're going to talk about where you were, what brought you into YouTube that led you into this.
Okay, how many minutes should I try to?
I don't know. Maybe if you're talking too much, first.
If I'm talking too much, just give me a look.
Yeah, maybe if you're talking too much, I'm gonna go wrap it up.
Yeah. Okay. Let's see.
That's a good song. I like that song.
Like the Grammy song. You're talking too much.
Yeah. I'm just gonna pull the fucking mic out of your side.
Okay. Let's see. Where do I start? So I started before I did YouTube. I was an accountant.
Where?
In San Antonio, Texas.
Okay.
I was actually an auditor. I've been an auditor for like 4 years or something. So I got my master's and I went that route, business route. Okay, too boring.
Oh no, no, I'm no, like, bring you are a
master?
I thought that was the wrap it up sign.
Girl, I thought you had an associate. You have a master.
I'm like, bitch, what do I look like?
Oh my God. Like, you have an associate. No, I'm just kidding.
She's got brains, beauty,
I look
and
like
a brain.
I have
she didn't go to college.
Oh my God. I look like I didn't finish my associates, right?
That should be on a t-shirt for you. Brains, beauty, and a booty.
Mm.
Oh. Mm.
Okay. But a lot of people are like, I guess for a white girl, she has booty, but not enough for like
a booty?
The
general
girl,
you got
no,
booty.
You got
a
ass.
Booty.
She got a booty. It's the white girl with the booty. It's a booty.
Woody.
A booty.
I like it.
You remember
okay.
that song? That was a good song.
Woody?
There's a song called
There's Woody. A song?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, shit,
look it up.
Know.
I'm not going to sing it because
you did work at Hooters.
I did.
Oh, yeah. She was a Hooters girl. That's right.
I was a Hooters girl.
So were you going to Hooters while getting your master's?
Yes.
Oh, my God. You're like that stripper story.
Yeah,
that's
dope. Except I still have a dad, so.
Okay. Oh, my God.
Okay. I couldn't go all the way, but.
Okay, so.
You have a dad don't mean you can't have daddy issues.
I'm kidding. Yeah, I have zero daddy issues.
Nikki doesn't want to feel excluded.
I got you, Nikki. We're good.
Okay, so you get your master's, you're working as an auditor.
Yeah, and then over time I just realized it was boring as fuck. It wasn't what I
How long
expected.
Did you do it for?
It was about 4 years.
Oh, okay.
So I went from being like a staff into a senior. Like I got promoted. I was making more money. It was all good, but it was like, is this really my life? It was pretty boring.
Damn, she got her master's.
Oh.
I know. It makes her sexier, right?
Right?
Turning Bo's on.
She had a big girl
you
job.
You want to meet up later, Bo?
No. Hey,
go under the table.
Can we fuck while you hug your diploma?
Or your degree?
That'll be great.
It's like, so basic, though, to have a master's in business. Come on, y'all. Give me too much.
Oh, yeah. Real basic.
Yeah, anyone could do that.
Yeah.
Yeah. We all have it.
Okay.
And then, so I met Joe online.
From
Just Kidding Films. Yeah. Mm-hmm. On Instagram. And we started dating long distance.
Can I say what you told him? The line that he tells us that
okay,
you told him?
I'll say it.
Okay.
Because he likes to make it as if it was the first thing I fucking told him.
Yeah. Like, I was like, damn, she's a down ass bitch. You guys have to hear this.
We were talking for like a month, just texting back and forth. And then eventually I was kind of like trying to get him to come see me. And so I said some line about, you can come to Texas. We've got, you know, some barbecue and we can fuck or something. Yeah.
Meat and fuck. It's what guys
yeah,
like.
Yeah.
It's what guys
it's
like.
It's like double
oh
meat.
My
yeah.
God.
Oh,
wow. Wait, who slid into whose DMs first?
Oh, so yeah. I was following him on Instagram as like a fan, I guess. And then I
what
remember.
What a star fucker.
No.
Oh my.
No, see, guys, dreams do
I wasn't
true.
Even into Asian wow. guys at all. So dream. It wasn't even on my radar.
How are we going to start with the come up story? Like the greatest come up story right? of all time.
Right?
Oh my
Yo,
God.
Yo, so you're telling me that if I send enough nudes to Michael B. Jordan,
no.
it might work.
I didn't send any nudes.
Fuck. Okay, let me
Did
just
you
copy
comment
what you
on
said.
His photos a lot.
No,
just butt pics, guys.
Comment a lot.
Just butt.
Who DM'd who first then?
So Joe. So I think I probably commented like once or twice.
So you did.
Yeah, she slid
just
in it.
Commented in. On his
you know
posts,
what you're
like
doing.
As a public figure. No, I was not even attracted to Joe.
Oh,
yeah,
seriously?
I could see that
happen. Then
I've seen Joe.
So he slid. So he slid he's into the DMs asking about my dog Maddie because she kind of looks like a Shiba, but she's like huge.
Ooh.
So she's not a Shiba, but he's like, "Is that a Shiba?" And I'm like, "No." And then we just kept talking.
How did
so
you feel when you saw? Profile? How did you feel when you saw Joe Jitsukawa sent you a message on Instagram?
Well, it said JoJo at the time.
Oh, JoJo, yeah.
I was like, "Oh shit, this is a YouTuber." That I've seen, like,
oh,
that's crazy.
Yeah,
but I wasn't like, oh my God, I want to fuck him.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay,
I wasn't wow. into him like that. Yeah, I fell for his personality. Okay,
That's yeah,
I love that.
We've seen Joe. We know.
Yeah,
we
yeah,
know.
Yeah.
yeah. I'm just.
He's like a Bobby.
I love Joe.
Oh yeah.
Okay, so after that.
Then yeah, so we dated for a year and then, he just kind of inspired me to be like, well, my life's not over. And if I'm not happy with the job I'm doing, I can take a break from it. I can come back to it in the future. I can just quit it forever. And then, you know, I was going to re-sign my lease in Austin. And he was like, how about you just come out to LA? So, like, I decided to just fuck all of it and move here.
That's wow. amazing.
So I did that.
Yeah.
It's been hard, though, because it's definitely a super transition. And, like, I never wanted to be in entertainment.
But you have a master's. You can. I feel like you can do, like, anything.
Yeah.
Both.
Still I can't. So
it's kind of like,
so a master's is kind of like Tic Tacs at this point. It doesn't even matter. Like,
it
in the real world.
Girl, at
in
least
the real
you have world, a Tic Tac. Shit.
Yes, yeah. Mm-hmm.
My breath over here stinking.
You tell it.
You got a master's and no student loans, and you
got
a ring on your finger.
I got student loans.
We don't have to tell.
No. We successful. We don't got debts.
I'm gonna be doing this ad read later, so you guys pay good attention to it.
She's gonna read it like a college graduate.
Yeah.
Okay. So then, so he persuades you to move in with him, and then what happens? How did you end up in YouTube?
Well, he's a YouTuber, and I wasn't working anymore because I just said fuck it to my job and my career, and then so I just started showing up, like vlogging with him, and then eventually he just had me like show up for some JK Film stuff. But yeah, it's been a slow burn on the whole entertainment thing.
Cause I know that you're still like kind of holding back a little bit, trying to figure out if you want to. And then this is the year that you started.
Yeah. I was like, I guess I'm here. Like I've been in LA for like 4 years now and I haven't really tried at all. I've just been like, I guess I'll show up. And then I'm on set and I'm like, oh, I don't like it. I'm scared. And then so I don't really push myself into the whole being seen thing. So I don't know. I like privacy and I'm scared of like being in front of the camera, but I'm getting better.
But you're literally on a podcast now.
I know. So I don't know how I even got here. Like, how did I get here? I don't know. I'm just here.
What was the point where you're like, fuck it. Like, I'm just going to do it and I'm going to commit to it.
I think it was around New Year's this year or like December last year. I was kind of like, I'm just going to give it 100% this year. And if it still doesn't feel like it's going in a great direction, then I can just go back to my career or like try something else. Because I just felt like I was in a kind of in a middle zone, like 1 foot in, 1 foot out. I'm not really trying. So I'm not really getting anywhere. I'm not seeing any results from any direction. So I was like, well, I got to just push 100%.
That's really rad, though, because you have the luxury of having both sides. Like, if you really want to go back to corporate 9-to-5, you have that master's degree that Bose loves so much.
Yeah.
And if he decides to go in entertainment, you have, like, the whole crew here that you can work off of, too.
Yeah.
So you have the luxury of both sides. So it's really awesome.
It is a good place to be. And I think I wasn't appreciating my situation enough. So I decided to try to appreciate it a little bit more and, like, jump in a little bit harder.
That's powerful, bitch.
Yeah, I felt
that. I was in love with you right now.
Yeah.